What is up, Soul Warriors? I know it has been forever. I have taken like 3 weeks off of social media. I'm going to tell you why I took that time off. And I'm also going to tell you what is going on energetically in the world right now and why things are going a little bit crazy. I felt like I needed more time off, but this, what is happening right now, it has to be said. So let me start with what's happening in the world, in the universe. So Ascension's going down. If you don't know what Ascension is, very quickly. So the whole thing about Ascension is kind of difficult to say in just a few minutes, but essentially the goal is that every single human break out of their, what they think they know about the world and see what is really true about the world, right? We are very black and white as humans. We're very, well, where's the proof? Like, show me the evidence, right? Like, we're very fearful of everything. And we don't want to look stupid. We don't want to believe in something that then turns out not to be true. And then, again, like, feeling dumb. We don't want to be duped. We want to be always on the defense so that nothing bad can happen to us. Like, that's always a human. And in Ascension, we need to go from that to believing in the fact that you have a higher self, that you are made of pure love and light, and that you are powerful enough to create whatever life you want. And that life is not happening to you. You are doing everything. Like, whatever you see around you is a direct reflection of what's happening inside. So we need every single person to be able to see that. And that's Ascension. And Ascension is no longer optional. It's happening. And you can't stop it. It's going down. And every single thing that's going on right now on the earth plane is in an effort to wake up every single human. Wake up. Being woke. You know, all that. And it's hugely important because it's affecting every single person. And it doesn't have to affect you in the way that it might be, right? Like, these are all lessons to be learned. But a lot of us see lessons as, like, these horrible things. And so people have a very skewed view of what's going on. And that's why I'm talking about this in my membership and everywhere. It's kind of all I'm talking about on my membership right now because it's hugely important. So that's Ascension as a whole. I know I talk a lot about, like, psychic gifts and, like, cool things you can do. And of course, that's also part of it. But the deepest part of it is learning your karmic lessons, releasing trauma, releasing everything that holds you down, all your blocks, all the negative energy within you, so that you can be the powerful, clear soul that you are. And we're humans, will never not be triggered. Like, we experience intense emotions. Like, that's what it is to be a human, right? But there's a difference between being triggered because you're not solving your shit and being triggered just because you're a human and you experience emotion. So right now, in Ascension, and the only way I can describe this is it just looks like a gigantic portal to me. And in the membership, I told people last month that this portal was going to be happening. And here we are. So this portal, imagine the earth needs to shed herself, right? And we need to shed ourselves in order to elevate to 5D. And it's important to say that time and space don't actually exist in the universe. So you're not actually going up anywhere in dimensions. Dimensions are all existing within each other, but we are moving to 5D energy. And so 3D things are a little bit hard right now. Okay, you just go sit down. There, the earth is now moving through this portal, and the best way I can describe it, and if you have been feeling this way, then you need to watch the rest of this video and listen to what I'm saying. So this portal is bringing about a crazy acceleration of karmic lessons. So if you have been feeling really emotional, if you've been feeling like you're getting hit with, like, lesson after lesson, or like there's, or if maybe you're not that far in your spiritual growth process yet, so you don't understand it's a karmic lesson, but you're like, I just feel like I'm getting triggered right, left, and center, getting triggered by things from the past coming up again and, like, haunting you, and you just can't get away from it. All of these things, there's other, being really sensitive to different kinds of foods more than normal, being really, really tired, just feeling kind of like doom, like everything's doom, the world's ending, like all of these kind of emotions are being brought on by this portal that Earth is going through. And this is one portal of many during the ascension process. So this isn't a one-time thing, but when you go through, like if you take advantage of what the portal can give you, then you won't experience that drama again. Okay, so that's why I'm making this video, because I want to help you. I want to save you. I want to help you save yourself and show you how to make it through this portal. And so that's actually the reason why I have been gone, because it's crazy because I felt this portal coming, but I didn't know what was going to happen. I just felt like we are going to be upgrading like intensely, like the Earth. And then I asked my guides, like, I'd like to highlight what karmic lessons I have left, because I want to be done with this stuff now, you know? And then a few days later, they hit me with 4 lessons simultaneously in one event. So I have been dealing with that, shedding that. I've had a lot of trauma in my life that I'm not really ready to talk about right now, but I've had a lot of trauma that I'm now committing to looking at, staring at, coming to terms with, and transmuting. And I am saying this for all of you. I really, really encourage you to do the same if you are feeling any of the things that I just said earlier, because this is an insane opportunity for you to release karmic lessons at a rapid pace. Only when you release karmic lessons and blockages as a result of those karmic lessons can you do this kind of work. Like if you are someone who's really into spiritual stuff, once you release blocks, your meditations get insane. Your psychic gifts start coming out more. Like all of your empathic gifts start becoming heightened. Like so much starts happening. And you start to understand how to move things in your life and use law of allowing in the best way possible, okay? And you can look in your timelines, you can look at, it's just the what you're able to achieve. And again, if this is very much exciting you right now and you're not a member already, go to the link in my bio, because this is what we're doing now. This is literally all we're working on now. So there's just a lot happening. And so I have a list for you of things that you can do to help yourself speed up this process. Only if you're ready. That's the thing. That's why I literally fell off the face of the planet for the last 3 weeks, because I just, it was very jarring. It was very traumatic, like re-traumatizing, but necessary, absolutely necessary. And now I'm still kind of in the, what happens when you release a karmic lesson is even when you release it, there's still kind of just this like black smoke that has to continue to, it's like when you put out a flame, but there's still smoke, and that smoke takes a little while to dissipate. That's kind of the stage that I'm in. But I forced myself to come and do this video because I'm just seeing, like, there are too many signs from spirit of people suffering and not knowing why they're suffering. And I know why the suffering, so I need to say something. All right. So here are the steps you can take to speed up your karmic lessons. And I don't want to hear anyone saying, actually, I'm healed and I don't have any more lessons. You will for the rest of your life. The rest of your life will be learning lessons. Do you have any idea how many times you've been alive? On Earth, on other planets, in other universes? You have been incarnated so many times. Do you think you have no trauma left? You have I literally just uncovered something that's like millions of years old. And me right now, this life is the first life that uncovered it. So I'm telling you, unless you are a tiny little baby soul, which I don't think any of you watching this are, you do not have, there's no finish line. There's no finish line. It's always uncovering lessons. Now, you have bigger karma. You have bigger karma that affects you versus like this. There's, once you get rid of like the big boulders, then the smaller stuff kind of, it's not as triggering or shocking to you. It's more like, okay, that makes sense. Let me release it. So what I'm talking about, this portal, is like the big chunks, okay? So the first thing to do is take all invitations, okay? So you can even ask, like even say like, hey, universe, I am open to receiving these lessons. No matter what it is, no matter how difficult it is, I'm ready to rock and roll. So once you declare that, it will begin like that. Like, I'm telling you, it is so fast. This portal is making everything happen so fast. So fast. So it literally feels like we have the opportunity right now to learn what would have been like a multiple year long lesson in a matter of a few weeks. So, you know, I'm all about efficiency. Okay, sorry. She was going all sorts of crazy. The oven's on. You're not allowed to jump on the oven when the oven's on. Okay. So anyway, I'm all about efficiency, and I am seizing this opportunity to speed up my healing process because I got lives to save. Okay. So I don't have time to be dealing with all these karmic lessons. So if you feel the same way, then declare that. That's number one. Okay. And then two, which is paired with that, is confronting all triggers. So again, if you are a member with us, you have the trigger journal. Be using that trigger journal. If you're not a member with us, sign up. I'm not trying to like plug the membership a million times. It's just like, I literally designed the membership for this moment. And now the moment is happening. And it's very exciting. So if you get triggered, if you are triggered, there's a reason for that. That you're not triggered for no reason anymore. Two things. One, you're not triggered for no reason anymore. And two, healing from karma and learning lessons is no longer optional. It was optional for you 10, 20, 30 years ago. It is not optional anymore. So if you do not take this opportunity now, we will get another portal. Like, that's what the information I was receiving was, there's going to be way more of these portals. But why push it off? Why not just take care of it, you know? So address every single trigger. So any trigger that you have, ask yourself, why does this trigger me? What in my shadow self or my inner child is the reason for this trigger? Really ask yourself that, okay? And get to the bottom of it. And you may find like instances. And if you have my book, also link in my bio to my book, there's a transmutation ceremony in there and the bonus material, and you can use that for this as well. So if you find the trigger, you can use that ceremony to release these triggers, because they're all within you at various points in your life, okay, or your past lives. So that's the second thing, okay? Now, that is for trauma. Oh, okay, Okay, there's actually a step three with that, which is allow the release to happen, okay? So you have to allow the release. It's not just a matter of like looking at it, oh, that's why I'm triggered. Oh, that's crazy, that happened when I was three. Oh my God, okay. You have to like, it has to come out. So cry it out. Dance it out, like move your body so that the tears can come, maybe like, or go in the bathtub. Like, I'm getting a very strong feeling of the energy can be stuck in your body. So make sure you're moving your body if it feels stuck, and then cry it out, have a tantrum, be so depressed, allow the feeling to rear its ugly head. Don't try to rationalize it. Don't let the ego get in here. If the ego tries to confront, Not going to be good. Okay. It's not going to leave. So allow yourself to feel the feelings and allow it to come out. Okay. That's how we get rid of the fire. And then we just have the smoke left. Okay. Now, other things that are physical related to this portal. You may be experiencing, again, an even more heightened allergies, I'll just say. So for example, I already can't eat like anything, but I've been like, now I can't even have, I've had only decaf coffee for the past 6 months, and now I can't even have decaf coffee. Like, every time I drink coffee, my stomach gets so upset and I start getting really bad acid reflux because I'm 85 years old. But so that may happen to you. Some people are telling me that they were allergic to dairy or they were allergic to eggs or whatever, and then they had it and they had like crazy reaction, crazy more than normal. So that could be happening. So eat good food. Eat food that makes you feel good inside. This is not the time to be kind of cavalierly eating whatever. But here's the thing too, you know, and I get this firsthand. If you're someone that when they are emotionally triggered, they want to just eat everything in sight, then, you know, don't be too hard on yourself. Do what you need to do to help this to come out, okay? So don't feel like, oh my God, and now I just binge eating, and now Mina just told me not to do that. I'd rather have the emotions come out, right? But I'm just telling you, this is a reason. If you're feeling like your body's rejecting a lot of stuff, like, this is why. So drink loads and loads of water. Loads of water. I normally have about 3 liters of water a day, like, not during this portal. And now, even that, I'm going to bed really thirsty every night. So have as much water as you possibly can. Limit alcohol, limit sugar, limit any like stimulant. Okay. So limit anything. You know what's bad for you. Okay. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you everything's bad for you. You know, limit those things. Okay. Because the body is so sensitive right now. This portal is crazy, crazy, crazy. And it's amazing because you're going to be getting so much like cool knowledge and cool healing. And it's also just the body's very sensitive. So if you're having digestive issues right now, and you don't know why, or you're just having kind of like body problems in general, this is why. Okay. So make sure you're drinking loads of water, avoid things you're allergic to, and just kind of avoid junk as much as you can in general. Even if you go from like having it 5 days a week to 4 days a week, that's good. Just anything you can possibly do. And we are about a fourth of the way through this thing. Again, time and space don't exist. So I have been, again, I said 3 weeks was when it hit me. So I can't help but think that that's kind of when we like started moving through this thing. And I did receive that we are 25% of the way through. Now, does that mean that you have to be feeling this way for many more months? No. The information I got was that once you have purged what you need to purge, then you're done. If you purge everything within the next, like, however many, like 2-3 weeks or whatever, you don't have to keep feeling the way that you're feeling. It's kind of like, it's like when you have to throw up, you know, like if you like drank too much or you have food poisoning or whatever, and you're like, I'm not going to throw up. And then you just try to sleep, right? Everyone's been there. Don't act like you haven't been there. And then all of a sudden you wake up and you're like, I need to throw up right now. And then you go and do it. And then what? You feel so good. You're like, oh, it feels like it's gone. Like, it feels like it truly is just gone. That's exactly the way these emotions are working. So it just needs to be gone. And so don't worry about anything else. Like, don't feel like, oh God, we're only a fourth of the way through this. If you do what you need to do, then you'll be done. And what they were telling me was the future portals, once you're kind of done with this stage of it, like the growing pains part, that the future portals are actually really fun because you manifest, because everything is heightened. It's not just the pain. It's everything. Like, it's abundance, manifestation, like it's love, like everything is accelerated. It's not just the negative that's accelerated. So you're free to play. Like, this can truly be your playground, you know? So that's why I'm really encouraging you guys. And that's all for my list. Like, movement. I forgot about that. You gotta move. You need to be, I'm not saying like go do like CrossFit or whatever. Like, you don't need to do that. Just go for a walk. Or even in the morning, like when you sit up in bed, just do some stretches, do a little Kundalini yoga, which is literally just like going like this, you know, you can do like whatever, do whatever feels comfortable to you, but do some movement. Don't let the body go stagnant. Okay. So is that all? Yes, that's all. That is all. So please go through this because I want you guys to, I don't want anyone to have to go through this longer than they have to. Because this was pretty gnarly. So do the work, solve what you need to solve. You know the ways that you're being shady. Fix those things. You know the ways that, you know the things that are calling for you to heal, okay? Fix those things. Resentment, judgment, follow the triggers, all of that. Do it. You better freaking do it. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to live the magical life, okay? So that's all I have to say for now. I will update as things progress. And until next time, check out my Instagram and social media stuff is linked down below. And if you have any questions for me, anything like that, please send me an email, write a comment, and I'll talk to you guys next time.